Now, let's see about spreading coefficient. What do you mean by spreading coefficient? Spreading coefficient says, okay, if the spreading of any ointment is not good, if ointment is not spreading on your skin, so what should I include in that ointment to make that ointment to spread? So for that, you should know what should I increase the surface tension of ointment or should I decrease the surface tension of ointment such that the spreading of ointment on the skin will occur. We'll see further. Before deriving the equation for spreading coefficient, you should know two terms. Work of cohesion and work of adhesion. Work of cohesion means you are doing some work to separate a cohesive molecules, same molecules. Okay, work of adhesion means you are doing some work to separate different molecules. What do you mean by this? We'll see this. Okay, consider a hypothetical cylinder made up of liquid L. Consider a hypothetical cylinder made up of liquid L and its cross-sectional area is 1 centimeter square. Hypothetical cylinder is made up of liquid L and its cross-sectional area. Cross-sectional area means if I cut this liquid like this, the area which you get is 1 centimeter square. Now break this hypothetical cylinder into two parts. Okay, break the hypothetical cylinder into two parts. After breaking, what you will get? Two cylinders like this. You will get a two cylinder. Break the cylinder from the middle to two cylinders. What you did now? You created two new surfaces. Initially, this cylinder has only one surface here. By breaking it, you have created two new surfaces and those new surfaces have their own surface tension. I am writing like this. Because it is made up of same liquids, liquid and liquid, by breaking the cylinder into two parts, you have created two new surfaces and they have their own surface tension. Now, previously we know that work done is equal to surface tension into area. Now here, as we are breaking a hypothetical cylinder made up of same liquid, means molecules are same, so we are doing some work of cohesion. So work of cohesion is equal to what you did by breaking the hypothetical cylinder. What you created? You created two new surfaces which has their own surface tension, two into surface tension of liquids. What I mean to say is take this surface tension plus take this surface tension, which can be written like this. 2 into surface tension of liquid. That is called a work of cohesion. We saw about work of cohesion, we will see about work of adhesion. Now this time, consider a hypothetical cylinder which is made up of a liquid and substrate and has a cross-sectional area of 1 centimeter square. When I break this hypothetical cylinder, we do some work and we'll break the hypothetical cylinder into two parts. You separate the liquid part, you separate the solid or substrate part. What you did, you have created two new surfaces. They have their own surface tension. Surface tension of liquid and surface tension of substrate. Initially, before that, as these two are different molecules, here we have interfacial tension between liquid and substrate. Okay, now what is work of adhesion? Work of adhesion means by doing some work, you have created two new surfaces. They have their own surface tension. Liquid surface tension and solid surface tension. Minus, initially we have interfacial tension between them and you have broken the interfacial tension. I explain once again. Work of adhesion means you have created two new surfaces by breaking this hypothetical cylinder which has their own surface tension, liquid surface tension and substrate surface tension, and previously this has its interfacial tension between them and you have broken that interfacial tension. Okay, it is represented. I am representing minus sign because you are breaking the interfacial tension and creating two, so I am putting plus sign here. This is called your work of adhesion multiplied by area. This whole thing is multiplied by area because work done or energy is equal to surface tension into area, as area is 1 centimeter square, I am not representing it here. Now we will see what is spreading coefficient. Spreading coefficient means work of adhesion minus work of cohesion. Why? You can ask me why adhesion minus cohesion? Because when you apply ointment here, the attraction between ointment molecule and skin should be more, means adhesive force should be more than the cohesive force. Cohesive force of what? Ointment. If ointment molecules are pulling each other, assume this is an ointment, this is skin, we have ointment here. Within the ointment, if the molecules are pulling each other with more force, that is work of cohesion is more, then the ointment will not spread. If the attraction between ointment molecule and skin or substrate is more, then the ointment will spread. It will spread when there is more attraction between ointment and skin. So I am writing adhesion minus cohesion. So substitute the formula. Work of adhesion is what? Just now we saw. Surface tension of liquid plus surface tension of substrate minus interfacial tension of liquid and substrate. Minus work of cohesion, we saw previously it is 2 into surface tension of liquid. Cancel the common terms, this and this will get cancelled. We can write remaining is surface tension of substrate minus interfacial tension of liquid and substrate minus surface tension of liquid. This can also be written as interfacial tension plus surface tension of liquid. This formula is your formula for spreading coefficient. What it says? We will see what it says. It says for the liquid to spread, the whole thing should be positive. Then only spreading coefficient is positive and the liquid or your ointment will spread. When this thing will become positive? When your, this liquid is your ointment. When your ointment surface tension is less, if this is less, whole here this part will become less and we get a positive value for the equation. Then it indicates as the spreading coefficient is positive, it indicates spreading is occur. That what it says. It says keep your surface tension of ointment less so that it will spread. Okay, that what this equation is saying. I explain once again. In this equation, substrate means, let's assume it as skin. Skin surface tension you can't change. Interfacial tension between ointment and liquid, we can't change, it will be constant, okay. But what is changeable property here is surface tension of liquid, it means ointment. Liquid here is ointment. In this equation, to get a positive value, if you decrease this value, the whole value will be positive. So, if you decrease the surface tension of liquid, that is ointment, the whole value will decrease and there will be a positive value for spreading coefficient and the liquid will, or the ointment will spread. So, if your ointment is not spreading, you have an ointment which is not spreading, incorporate surfactants or polar agents. If you incorporate surfactants or polar agent within the ointment, due to presence of surfactant, surface tension of ointment will decrease and there will be a more chance that the ointment will spread easily. Thank you.